Today I just wanted to share a useful way to move around in your blueprint sources. I often have to try new concepts and tinker with the program, and so it's often difficult to keep track of what is where, and it's also tedious to move around in larger blueprints. Yes, there are the control number keys which allow to define jump destinations in blueprints, but that doesn't really help. This is of course the opposite of software engineering and structured programming, which normally creates a well-defined environment, and the academic solution to large blueprints is of course to break it up into several functions. But as said, this isn't useful when being in the stage of trial and error programming. So to not lose track and to ease the navigation, I like to use what I call an index blueprint. In a normal blueprint, you can double-click onto, for example, an event call, and the editor directly jumps to the definition. My index blueprint is a separate blueprint, which doesn't have any function for the program execution, but simply contains function or event calls on which you can double-click to go to the desired position. So to start, I switch to a reasonable folder and create a standard blueprint and call it, for example, _index. Inside this blueprint, I can now add calls to functions or events of interest. The easiest way to do this is to right-click into the area and then deactivate the context-sensitive button. I now can enter the name of the function or event I want to add and add it to this blueprint as usual. The call also contains a destination object, so it's visible to which blueprint this call belongs. If the name doesn't show up, check that you have indeed deactivated the context-sensitive option. In the same way, you can also add jump destinations at arbitrary locations by simply adding lone custom events like this. For example, I want to add a destination here. I add a custom event, call it for example m- for marker, and now add a call to it in my index. And so can now jump straight to this position. A downside is that since they aren't connected, they won't be moved with the code if you reformat the code. You may experiment with connecting them to avoid this, but this on the other hand may disturb the formatting of the main function. By arranging the calls appropriately and adding reasonable inline comments, and maybe also adding colored comment bubbles, it's now easy to navigate through my spaghetti code.